Hello, I'm Tristan from Smart Home Point. One of the things I've learned over the years is that a product's marketing doesn't always reflect the reality. Or the marketing is technically correct, but in practice it's misleading. What am I rambling about? Well, I will tell you. Ring's cameras and doorbells are mainly full HD quality, apart from the Ring Pro 2, the doorbell, which offers something a bit different. However, whilst full HD sounds great, the reality is that you probably won't be able to make out the plate numbers of passing cars, for example, or even the face of someone running past, especially at night. Whilst this is partly due to full HD not always being sufficient for security cameras, it's also because of something called bitrate.
Bitrate. Boring.
Wait, this is actually a crucially important topic. As BorrowLenses explains helpfully, bitrate is the amount of data encoded per second when you shoot video. The higher the bitrate, the higher the quality of your video. Many people confuse bitrate and resolution. They're actually independent of one another. Resolution is the pixel size of your video. It does not necessarily determine the actual quality of your video. And they go on to give another important bit of information. Bit. Get it? Never mind. If we kept the bitrate constant and we shot two videos, one at 1080p, full HD, and one at 4K, you would notice that the 1080p video might actually look better. That's interesting. Sounds surprising, but it's interesting. So, what's the recommended bitrate and hence quality of 1080p video? Well, if you actually go on YouTube's own help pages, if like me you produce YouTube videos, you can click the link in the description as well, they make clear that full HD video should be shot at 8 or more megabits per second. So what does Ring shoot at? It's actually a dismal 2.5 megabits per second. This is what 480p video should be shot at. So whilst Ring advertise full HD quality, the bitrate and hence quality is actually closer to 480p resolution. This benefits Ring because the recording file sizes are much smaller, saving them lots of money on storage and bandwidth costs. But this disadvantages us, the consumers, because the image quality of these full HD recordings are actually worse than you would expect. It's a bit like if you turn on a tap somewhere where there's a water leak nearby, causing the water pressure to be really low. Yes, water is coming out of the tap, but it doesn't really wash your hands in the way you'd expect. It just isn't as good. So, Ring's bitrate is no good. But turning back to the resolution itself, I don't think that full HD is sufficient anymore. Eufy have offered 2K resolution for quite a while, and this captures more than double the number of pixels, both vertically and horizontally. Even though, admittedly, Eufy's cameras, the bitrate on them isn't really great either. To be honest, it feels like Ring should be stepping up the resolution and the bitrate of their cameras and doorbells. Now, before you shout at me,
oh my god, the Ring Pro 2 does have better resolution, you noob!
Rude. Whilst the Ring Pro 2 doorbell does offer head-to-toe resolution, as they call it, it actually has a lower horizontal resolution. In some cases, the Pro 2 seems to actually have worse image quality from what I've seen due to the fishbowl type effect that the head-to-toe resolution offers and has to display like in the app. Plus, the new Ring Floodlight Cam Wired Pro, which was released after the Pro 2, offers standard full HD again, suggesting the Ring have no plans to actually take the step up to a higher resolution in their future products. Ring's version of full HD seems like it's here to stay. With all that said, I wanted to provide some specific examples of how resolution and bitrate actually appear and work together. This video is being shot at 4K resolution at 60 megabits per second bitrate, but I wanted to give some examples of what happens when you start tapering down both the resolution and the bitrate. So let's start loop mode by saying, I am Groot, 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 I am Groot. So, as you can see, I am Groot. No, wait, what was my point? Oh yeah, it's not just that the resolution that matters here, it's actually the bitrate as well. I think that Ring are being a little bit disingenuous by advertising full HD quality, when in reality the bitrate is so poor they often can't pick up important information from the recordings. Of course, it's easy for me to sit here and rant about all this, but what's the solution? Eufy and Nest don't offer a better bitrate. Well, the answer is that if you really care about resolution and bitrate, i.e. video quality, then you'll probably want to avoid cloud-based cameras and doorbells altogether. These intentionally scale back the bitrate in order to make the file size smaller. The real solution here is to use cameras that store locally, such as the ones from ANNKE, which can record in 4K and a 16 megabits per second bitrate. These record to a local NAS, but the recordings can still be viewed via an app in the normal way. The only downside is that if your NAS fails, you lose all your recordings, unless you have backups, of course. The other big downside is that there's currently no high-resolution, high-bitrate smart doorbells available, only cameras, within the mass market. I talk about this more on my blog, and you can check out the link in the description. But at the time of filming, there's only one 4K smart doorbell from Fresh, and it's still in beta stages. My main suggestion is that if you do want great image quality, use a 4K locally stored camera for security, and then a smart doorbell for convenience. And that wraps up today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button to tell YouTube that more people should watch this video. Please also consider subscribing to my channel and also clicking the bell icon to get notified when a new video comes out. Thank you.